We're about 3 or 4 miles from Oklahoma in Wichita County, Texas.
Look at this one over here, Silas. Well, it doesn't come out vertically. You want to set a trap?
Yeah.
Trap and a camera.
I'm a graduate student at Texas State University in the Wildlife Ecology Program. And we are surveying for Texas kangaroo rats. They hop on their back legs like a kangaroo, hence the name. It looks a lot like your pet store gerbil, about 1.5 inches as big, with a white tail tip. It is a state threatened species. So it does seem to be pretty rare geographically. It's only been found in 11 counties in Texas, and within the past 20 years, only found in 5 of those 11 counties.
They're about the handsomest rodent that you can find.
If we lose it here, it is done as a species. It would be an easy species to pay a little bit of attention to and keep on the map. Got anything over there?
There's 2 or 3.
Today we're surveying to see if kangaroo rats are using the same burrows and areas as they were this summer.
There's quite a bit of burrows over here. Fresh kick out. Lets us know that it's active and not abandoned.
We're setting motion sensitive cameras that will record video in infrared. And we're also setting spring-loaded box traps. I'm gonna bait the area.
Are we seeing just the last vestiges of populations that are hanging on? We don't know. I think that's the reason Texas Parks and Wildlife and the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service want to find that out.
Right at the next intersection, there should be a burrow.
Well, we are assisting Texas State University on Texas kangaroo rat research, and in addition, we're actually funding them through our state wildlife grant program. Species that's not federally endangered yet, but it's a species of concern for us. It's obviously declining. We don't have a lot of great information on this species, so we're trying to learn as much as we can. But it's a species that we're concerned about, and it's been a concern for a while. I haven't seen one yet. I've seen some other species of kangaroo rat, but not the Texas kangaroo rat, so I'm hoping to.
More times than not, we'll get them on the camera and not in the traps. They're rather trap shy. We're giving up. Fingers crossed for some rat activity.
Any rare animal is difficult to study, especially species like this that are nocturnal and they're elusive, and they're not easy to find.
Roadside surveys have been kind of a survey method of choice.
1,500 survey miles total, so that's driving around at night between 10 p.m. and about 5 a.m.
The success is always low. You gotta cover a lot of miles to find a very few individuals.
It gets a little bit tedious, and some nights we went without seeing a single one. Went home a little upset. He's back out. He's like groundhogging us. Up, up, down.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Been dark about an hour and a half, 2 hours, and I already got some activity. Cotton rat.
Well, we only saw one.
Two kangaroo rats. Pretty quick. Squeeze a few hairs off to get a DNA sample.
Sorry, buddy.
Then we're gonna weigh him 93 grams. And then we're gonna get some standard length measurements on them. 42 millimeters for hind foot, ears 8, and tail. Right at 210.
Oh, the tail.
All right.
We would like to find enough of these animals to say that, okay, here's a species that may have been in decline. if we learn enough about it, we can, instead of putting it on the endangered species list, implement some management strategies.
It's one of our prime objectives at Texas Parks Wildlife. Hey. Keep things off the endangered species list.
80 grams. The bag's 10 grams.
Oh, yeah,
babe. Oh, another Texas kangaroo rat. Nice.
If they exist in these roadside habitats, they may be evolutionarily adapted to fire and bison herds, those disturbed environments that would occur after those events. They hop, adapted to wide open spaces, bare ground created by some agricultural practices, by grazing, may be very suitable for these animals.
Short grass, well grazed, lots of areas between grass so they can move around freely. Edges of farm fields where you have the little bit of bare ground next to the fence, and that seems to be their ticket.
They are unique. It's part of this ecosystem that's been here for a long, long time. Why not care for it?
They don't have any detrimental effect to the landowners.
They don't invade houses, don't dig large holes, they don't disrupt farming practices, so they can exist here very easily.
There's more interest in non-game species than there has been in the past.
We really need to have more natural history information on the whole gamut of wildlife. We know really very little.
This is great information.
181.
We're learning more about the habitat needs of the species, its biology, its life history. And it's very valuable as we try to develop recommendations for private landowners.
So this guy is ready for release.
Any key to the future of this species is going to be through private lands.
This project was funded in part by a grant from the Wildlife Restoration Program.